Hi everyone, this is Aminder from Team Aminder, your online training coach, and back again this time with a video variation which is bar dips. So this video is in response to the two variations which we have put up on our Facebook. It was one limited range and one was a bigger range of doing a bar dips. And before we head towards that thing, let me tell you a little about bar dips. Bar dips itself is not a good exercise to be done in any sense, whether it is a low range or a high range. It's a contraindicated exercise for your shoulder joint, and which should be avoided altogether. But the topic is not related to that thing. The topic is which variations is good, so we'll be talking on that only. So let me tell you about the tricep. This is your tricep muscle, and we have three heads, so it means one muscle with the three heads. Two heads actually only crosses the elbow joint, and there is one head which is a long head that crosses the elbow joint also and the shoulder joint also. So the two heads. So any movement which is creating on the shoulder will create a lengthening and a shortening effect of the long head muscle of the tricep. But itself is an elbow extension. Anything that has been created in the elbow extension will be hitting the tricep altogether. So the question, I'm just going to repeat it, which variation is good? And we got a number of answers on this thing. So I'll just tell one of the person to come over here to show the question that was put up over here on FB. So this was a question, this was a bar dip. And in this bar dip, one variation was when he comes, that's it. It comes up and goes up, limited range. And in another, he's going to go low, very low towards it, very low, go down. And this is the range of motion which is going to come up, and that's thank you. And that was a two variation question which was put, which is good, whether the low is good or a high is good. So before with that thing, its answer is just going to be in front of you when I'm going to talk about the anatomy. Anatomy is, we're going to see that the structure of the human body permits to do which range of the motion. Remember, exercise doesn't have any rule. Rules are only of the human body. If your human body joints permits you to do any sort of an exercise, it's all eligible to do it. But if your joints are not eligible to do it, you can't do that exercise. It's going to be spoilage to any joint. Every human being holds a different range of motion for all joints. So it depends upon person to person, what level he is doing it, he is eligible or not. Exercise doesn't have any rule, it is only the body rules. So you need to check the body rules whether they are eligible or not. Any exercise will be actually on the risk and a benefit paths. If you think that exercise has a lot of benefit, but it has a lot of risk also, that should be avoided exercise. And the bar dips is one of the exercises in which you increase the range of motion, you increase the benefit. Of course, the benefit range is going to increase when you increase the range of motion. The tricep muscle is going to be hugely involved, but along with that thing, the risk factor also goes along with it. So any exercise that increases the risk factor along with the benefit, I will put my hand on reducing the risk factor and keeping the benefits level high. So just check it out whether the human anatomy has that permission to do that exercise with what range. That all. So we have number of volunteers over here standing. Hello everyone.
Yes, sir.
So we're just going to see the range of motion of the human body, whether it permits us to do it or not. So you can just stand or facing that one side all together. You can just be a little over here. Come over here. Yes. Little ahead. So we have over here five volunteers who's going to show the human body potential of increasing the range of the shoulder joint. So the first is the flexion. So any movement we are doing from the shoulder has to be restricted. So we'll see what is the range of the joint of the shoulder from this to this. So human body can do it. So first we will tell them to take the shoulder up as much as they can do it without even getting into the trouble. So everyone can take their shoulder as much you can. Don't force your body to go beyond. So you can see that he has a nice range of motion on the flexion part. He also has a very nice one. He has a very, very over one. That's his. But over here you will see a person over here, a normal person, the human range of the shoulder at this point is just over here. It means far, far below the 90 degree angle. So he is into a very, very prone injury area of creating something on the shoulder joint over here. So everyone has it. We have another over here which is nice over there. So range of motion differs from person to person. Now when we get to the extension form, which is precisely the shoulder, a tricep exercise move, which is an elbow extension, a shoulder flexion. So we will reach to a first a maximum shoulder extension level which a person, human body can do it, and decide whether this exercise should be done or not done, and if it is done, what is the range of the motion that person can put in order to put that exercise. So all together, everyone, can you bring the shoulder down, bring the scapula, join the scapula, and try to take your arm as much as back you can. That's a shoulder extension range of a human body for different person. Can you see they are actually with the maximum? Even if he's trying to do it, he's opening the elbow outside. If I tell you just to close that thing, the range actually comes over here. Now over here you will see. You will see on doing the maximum, he's just over here. Doing anything above this, going anything above this thing is going to hamper the ligaments of this anterior portion of my shoulder joint, and it is going to be a big issue in a long run. If anything happens to my shoulder ligaments over here, anterior ligaments, you will not be able to do any exercise, because it's not just the ligaments, it's the inside socket also which has actually been pressed, and a lot of issue is going to be happening on the inside of the shoulder inside socket. But if we try to do over, we try to do it. So if we try to overpress it, if you see it is over here, and if I try to overpress it and take it as much as it can, there is a huge amount of stretch which is going to happen on the ligaments, on the anterior ligaments of my shoulder, which is going to be overstretched beyond its tolerance range. Even if you see over here, if I try to take it more high as much, the amount of ligaments over here are overly stretched beyond its tolerance range to actually see. If it is this much, I'm stretching it at that much, and that might get injured on the spot also. They will be getting injured in the long run. So it's better that we avoid. This is the maximum range. You decide your maximum range to do that exercise and further create a shoulder flexion and an elbow extension. Of course, the range of motion is going to be very less in this thing, but we are going to safeguard the exercise by taking care of the shoulder joint and giving still the benefit of the exercise to the tricep. Of course, the range is going to come less. Of course, it's going to be less, but yes, I am preventing the shoulder to get any odd thing, but prevention is for the shoulder. For me, his joint is going to be the prime thing rather than the tricep hitting or something or not, but still we will take the benefit of that thing. So that's the answer, and many of the guys have answered very nicely, and they will be awarded the t-shirt soon. And this was the thing, the range has to be decided as per your own human anatomy. Do take care of that thing. That was all for the video this time. We will be looking forward for the next videos for many other variations also. Till then, this is Aminder from Team Aminder. Goodbye. Have a nice week.